You don't want to miss this week's DevOps for Mobile Developers, because Abel and I are going to show you how to take a brand new app, publish it to GitHub, and do a full build in 15 minutes.
No way.
Yes. Tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to the second episode in DevOps for Mobile Developers. I'm James Montemagno, and my best friend has joined me yet again. Abel, how's it going, buddy?
Great. So happy I'm still your best friend.
Still my best friend. You made it a whole week.
Nice.
And in fact, I'm thinking 6 or 7 weeks. You'll be right at the top of this list.
All right.
So on the previous episode, we talked about what is DevOps, and also all the tools that we're going to use.
Yeah.
And specifically around mobile development, because it's a little bit different than some of the other kind of web development and back-end services you're deploying. So today I figured we'd start from the beginning.
Nice.
Like file new.
So like empty, nothing. From nothing to like a build.
To a build.
All right. Yeah. Let's see this.
Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go into Visual Studio, create a new project, and we're going to push our source code. So let's do that. Now, I'm going to come into Visual Studio, and I'm going to type in mobile here. And we'll have all sorts of mobile templates. We're going to create a mobile app for iOS and Android.
Okay.
That's going to be our focus. It's going to be a cross-platform app using our cross-platform UI, Xamarin Forms.
Okay.
And it's going to use a .NET standard library, share code. We can share with other projects here. But everything, like I said, we're going to show, like while we're going to demo with a Xamarin app, it actually applies to any mobile app. So whether you're using Xamarin Forms, Xamarin, or you have a Windows desktop application or a Mac application, anything like that. Kind of this process works very similarly.
Oh, that's great. So so just to be clear, what you're showing us, we can also do this for desktop apps as well.
Absolutely, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, we'll walk through that, yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to call this Hello DevOps.
Okay.
That seems like a good idea here. So let's do Hello DevOps. And we're going to create this project. And we have a bunch of different templates. I'm going to do a blank app. File new, blank app, but it has some NuGet packages, it has dependencies, it's not just blank, it has some stuff in it.
Okay.
And we're not even going to run the app, because we don't even need to at this point, because if file new doesn't run, then we got problems on our end,
so this should run.
So we're just going to save everything, it's going to restore the NuGet packages, but let's look at this project structure.
Okay.
I mentioned we have an Android app, an iOS app, and our .NET standard library. It's .NET standard, has some NuGet packages.
Cool.
Things are good to go. And inside of here, we're basically going to try to set up a continuous integration, kind of build, our first build for when I push code, Android and iOS build.
Okay.
And we're not going to generate a package. We're just going to do like a debug build.
Let's just compile it.
Let's just compile it, right?
So where are you going to store the source code?
So we're going to store this source code. Well, we have a few options. Well, here I'm going to first come into Visual Studio, and the bottom right, I'm going to actually add a Git source control here.
Okay, cool.
I'm familiar with Git. That's what I've used for the last decade or so, and that's what I'm going to use.
Nice.
What I love is that Visual Studio jumps in, says, hey, where do you want to push this code?
Yep.
I can push it to Azure DevOps, to GitHub, or my own remote repository. So maybe you have Bitbucket or your own source Git repository, you're good. We're going to put this on GitHub.
Perfect.
Just going to put it on GitHub.
All right.
I like to do it on GitHub because this is going to be kind of an open source collaborative project. So we're just going to do this.
Yeah.
I've already signed in. Let's create public. We'll say this is mobile DevOps project for mobile. There we go. And we'll publish it. And literally, what this will have created is not only my iOS, Android, .NET standard project. It's going to create my Git sort of local repository. It actually just published this to GitHub, so it's there.
Like wow,
it created a Git attributes, Git ignore files, and it has everything that I need.
That's about as easy as you can get.
Yeah, now I have source control. Like I literally just press two buttons.
That kind of blows me away because it literally was just a couple button clicks and bam, you're done.
And I'm done. It's
All
like
right.
done.
Code stored in source control.
Hooray, and we're done. Yeah, now what's cool is that I can create additional branches. So as I'm working on features, I can create branches. So if everyone doesn't commit to master, that's like the, I like to call that the truth branch. Like we ship from master.
Yep.
So I can create feature branches and then I can build those branches and I can kind of set that up myself.
Cool.
So we want to build this thing.
Right.
So in the first episode, we talked about we have Azure DevOps and we have App Center.
Correct.
Now, both of them offer cloud builds. Mm-hmm. Now, App Center, I'll talk about that, and then maybe you can talk about the cool things that that DevOps will do, and we'll set that up in the next video. But App Center here, what I'll show is that App Center itself is a series of mobile-specific build environments, but it does more than just build. I kind of call it the getting starting build because it has like an optimized path that it follows. I'm not going to call it a pipeline, okay? Because it's like, I'm going to build your app, and your app is built, and then you can do something with it. Okay. So I like to do this in, I only have just an app that I'm going to build, nothing special, or I'm just getting started like I am today, and I just want something to happen.
Sure.
App Center, though, the parts that we're actually going to use and do orchestration on are the testing, releasing, and monitoring it. Okay. And we're going to do that via DevOps, because DevOps is a lot more.
A lot more powerful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's get started there. And in the next video, we'll set up a CI full pipeline in DevOps.
Cool.
So we're in App Center, and I've created an account. You can log in with all sorts of things.
Okay.
On the left-hand side are all my organizations. I did Seattle Give Camp, so I have a lot of organizations. I do a lot of community work. And I have my Xamarin Show sort of organization here. Mm-hmm. So you can kind of create your companies. Maybe it's Abel's Rockstar group, and then, you know, and then I have a Xamarin group. And so these are my different parts here.
Cool.
And it's a little bit different. Like, we created a repo, and that has multiple apps. Mm-hmm. App Center thinks of each sort of project as its own separate app.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So you have an organization that has multiple apps, but an app is literally an iOS or an Android app.
Oh, okay.
So you don't think of it as a project. You think of my project is my app.
Got it.
So we're actually going to set up two apps. And inside of here, when I say new app, we're going to say hello DevOps Android.
Okay.
And then what I can say is I can give it different groups. So we're going to say this is going to be just my alpha kind of release type. That's just more of a sort of indicator for me later on of what this is. So I could build my app multiple times. Maybe I have a full one for the App Store, for instance.
Okay.
And then here, there's a lot of options. Notice we have iOS, Android, Windows, and Mac, and different platform technologies.
Got it.
This is very different than maybe other DevOps products because it's not a DevOps product. It's a series of things for your app.
Very specific to like mobile and desktop.
Very specific, yeah.
Okay, got
it. So I'm going to say Android, and then I'm going to say this is a Xamarin app.
Okay.
But notice that it has Unity Games, React Native, Java, Kotlin, any of your apps.
So it can be written in whatever mobile language you want to use.
Anything you want,
nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm going to say new app. This is going to create my new Android-specific app. Mm-hmm. They have SDKs that you can integrate into it because, like we mentioned, it's not DevOps. It has a bunch of DevOps services in it, but it gives you the ability to build, test, distribute, monitor your application, then do other things such as authentication, data, and push notifications.
Would it be fair to say that App Center is a collection of tools that are really useful for the mobile world?
Yes,
okay.
Absolutely. And what's cool is you can use one or many.
Okay.
So if you only want to use distribute, only use distribute. You can use as much or little. So for now, we're just going to set up a build, and here I can connect it to Azure DevOps, Bitbucket, or GitHub. Mm-hmm. So here, I've already logged in with my GitHub. That's how I actually created my App Center account.
Okay.
And here it's going to search all of my GitHub repos. So it's going to take a second to come up. And here we have, I typed in hello, and then I have hello DevOps.
Cool.
And boom. So this is going to show me all my branches. Mm-hmm. I have one branch. And what App Center does, it says, for every branch, you set up a different build.
Okay.
It's a different way of looking at it. I usually sort of set it up as a smoke test.
Okay.
So here what we're going to do is we're going to say configure this build. It automatically scanned my repo. It's kind of something cool. It's because it knows that it's a Xamarin Android project.
Yeah.
It's created a special sort of build configuration, and all of the services are very specific to Xamarin Android.
Got it.
It knows about me, knows about my app. Mm-hmm. And kind of it's done everything for me. It says, do you want it in debug or release? We're going to do a debug kind of smoke test.
Nice.
Here, it also gives me the ability to configure what version of Xamarin Android do I want to build on. Because mobile apps, you may need a different version of Android and Java SDKs and Xcode versions. And there's a lot of dependencies, right?
Sure.
And you can't have all of them installed on a machine at one time.
Right.
Like the, you know, a .NET Core, mm-hmm. you might have 20 SDKs installed, right?
Yeah.
You can just install one willy-nilly.
Yep.
But here, these are essentially, think of them as Mac VMs mm-hmm. in a way, you know, Mac build machines. I don't know if there's build machine agents mm-hmm. that are hosted up by App Center mm-hmm. that have specific versions of Android installed.
Cool.
So we'll use the default, the latest version.
Okay.
And that's nice because I select one, I know it's going to build, it doesn't change on me behind the scenes, and I can go back and pick it.
Yep.
There's a bunch of other things inside of here, like do I want to build with every push? Do I want environment variables, signing? It's sort of these kind of simplistic sort of starting points mm-hmm. For my app, but I'm literally just going to say save and build. And what this is going to do behind the scenes is set up a full sort of build infrastructure for this app.
Okay.
And now every time I publish code to it or do anything, it's going to look for the source code changes. Here it's going to sit and wait for a build agent to come up.
Yep.
And what's cool about this is when we talk about Azure DevOps is it's actually running in Azure VSTS, Azure DevOps like pipelines behind the hood.
Right. Yeah. I was going to say that looks awfully familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool.
And so now it's going to initialize the steps, do everything, but it's kind of sandboxed, mm-hmm. right? So it is this kind of getting started workflow where I know when you were talking about the ASP.NET version, there's a lot of different parts to it.
Yeah, right? A lot of parts.
So how does this compare to what you've seen in the past as far as like builds?
In some ways, it's super simple, mm-hmm. right? Because you can make the assumption, this is a mobile app, this is an Android app that you picked, and it's using Xamarin Technologies, yeah. and these are the versions.
Yep.
So based on that, there's a lot of manual stuff that I would have needed to do inside of Azure DevOps, Azure Pipelines. Mm-hmm. I would have to chosen the correct steps and stuff. It just kind of blows it all out for you.
Yeah.
So it's fast and easy.
It's fast and easy, but also not super configurable.
I was going to say, you're constrained, right? You can't really customize this to make it, like, for instance, if I happen to have a whole bunch of unit tests.
Yeah.
How do I run those? Right.
Correct.
So this is just, it's like a quick and dirty build.
I like to, that's what I think, like, right? I want to get something building. I want to prove to my manager mm-hmm. that I can set up a very quick build. And if I push code, I can see if it's going
to
fail.
And I noticed you didn't even have to set up a build agent, install all the stuff on a machine. It's just bam. It just click a button and it builds.
And it's there. And it just built my app in 1 minute.
That's sick. Yeah. That's awesome.
So now we'll do the same exact thing, but now we're going to do it for iOS.
Okay.
Because since that was an Android app, it has to know now that it's an iOS app.
Right.
So here I'm going to say hello DevOps iOS.
iOS.
That's kind of my best practice. You kind of know that it's Android because there's like an indicator, but mm-hmm. I like it in the name.
Sure.
Again, here we see different options. We obviously see Objective-C Swift. If I was to tap on Windows, there's UWP Unity, and then Objective-C Swift for Mac OS applications.
Cool.
But here I'm going to select Xamarin again. Here we'll just go ahead and say Alpha for funsies and say new app. So now I have like these multiple apps that mm-hmm. are in here, and I'm literally going to do the same thing. So inside of here, it's going to know what do I need to connect to. Every app is connected to a different repo. Mm-hmm. So if you had an app in a different repo, for instance, you're on, you know, Hello DevOps 2 or whatever, mm-hmm. You would have a different app for that. So here, it's master, click configure.
Okay.
And then pretty much the same. It's found different projects,
sure.
iOS projects. You build the solution instead of the project. Mm-hmm. It knows about that. Mm-hmm. Here, it knows about specific SDK versions, but specific to iOS.
Got it.
And then what's interesting here is we didn't see this in Android, and it says Xcode version.
Right.
Because Android has built-in Java dependencies and Android SDK, mm-hmm. but iOS has Xcode dependencies.
Right.
So you get to pick and choose, and if you go like further back in time, these things are going to change.
Got it.
This is important because you may have to build your application and compile against an older version. You're not ready to move on yet. It's a little bit complicated, but they have all the different pre-built things there.
Yeah. To really simplify the process.
They do. Check boxes, radio buttons, boom.
Yeah.
Again, here, the difference here is this is going to ask us if we want to build a device build or a simulator build. Mm-hmm. So here we're going to do simulator because it'll be quick and dirty. We're not signing it. We haven't gone to Apple. We haven't provisioned anything yet. We're going to say don't sign anything, like literally just build the quickest thing possible. And then we'll just go ahead and say save and build. And just like on Android, this is now going to kind of configure my iOS build for me. And then at least at this point, mm-hmm. within the last 15 minutes, we've taken file new, we've pushed it to GitHub, and we at least have a smoke test built in.
Yeah, you just created a build for iOS and Android, like you said, within 15 minutes, right? Yeah. Less because we've just been chatting.
We've just been chatting, yeah.
That impresses me because I know it would take me a little bit longer if I tried to do this inside of Azure Pipelines.
Yeah.
Or any build system, really.
Or any build system, too, because yeah. The difference here is like App Center, at least the build part of it is mm-hmm. super specialized, right? It's like yeah. so specialized.
Yeah.
And they kind of have that constraint system built in. Now, you may be saying like, well, maybe you're already building it in DevOps, right? Or maybe mm-hmm. you're using some other CI pipeline. The nice thing here is that while we're going to start in build, we're going to actually switch everything over to Azure DevOps mm-hmm. because what we're going to use App Center for, mm-hmm. not only is this great smoke test, which we can just leave in place, like why not have it build in multiple places for funsies?
Sure.
but we're going to use the UI testing, the distribution, and we can add in some analytics and crash reporting.
Cool. So, I can't wait to see those as well.
And that'll be important because we'll see exactly how Azure DevOps integrates with App Center to make it seamless together.
Nice.
But hey, in a few minutes, we're building. Let's see if our build for iOS is going to finish. We'll see how fast it is, right? That's what I like to see. Like we have these super fast, crazy machines. I was testing it earlier, and it looks like it's building. It's fun to just watch what it's doing sometimes, and it's copying files, yeah. doing things.
So I have a question while this thing is building. I noticed that you create a build for every branch,
yeah.
right? So if I happen to, like, I don't like long living branches because mm-hmm. they're a pain, right? So I, basically I create a branch to do my work and I try to merge into master as fast as I can.
Yeah.
If I create a branch, do I have to actually come in here and then say create another build specific for that branch?
That's a great question. So if we do that, right? So if we come in here into our project and let's create a new branch, we'll say hello DevOps. There we go.
Okay.
Create that branch mm-hmm. there. And I come back into here, so now it's finished, and I come into my build again, mm-hmm. we'll see it here.
Got it.
It's not configured, though.
You still need to click it and say, build this for me if somebody checks something in or something
exactly.
like that.
Exactly. So there's some nice things with that, which is, hey, you might be creating hundreds of branches.
Sure, sure, sure.
So don't do that on every single one, but then you're going to have to configure it. Yeah. So that is sort of a limitation or a strength based on how you develop.
How you want to do it.
So
to me, it seems like this is just, it's a really nice tool, right? Yeah. It's a nice tool for mobile developers.
It's a tool in your toolbox yes. if you choose to build it. And like based on what it does, it might be a good tool for you. Mm-hmm. But for me, like what's interesting here is that we're only building the mobile app. What happens when we build backend services?
Backend code, right.
Databases, right. You know, functions, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And that's where I think we'll take a look at how we transition this into Azure DevOps.
Cool.
Yeah. But hopefully you kind of get everyone, like everyone's got a little 101 of App Center build at least. Mm-hmm. But to us, we're going to do a whole bunch of great stuff in it.
Cool.
Awesome. Cool, Abel. Hope that you liked it. I don't know.
It was impressive. I'm impressed at how fast you just got your builds running. But it's super specialized and I feel constrained, right?
Yeah.
Because I want to do other stuff.
Yes.
And I'm like, but I can't, right? But if I just wanted to build it, compile it, make sure it works. And quick and dirty, send it to the store or something like that,
yes.
I can just use App Center to do all that.
Exactly. And in the next episode, you'll see how we break free of the constraints with Azure DevOps. Make Abel real happy. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this episode. We love your feedback on the shows. Go down to the comments below on YouTube or Channel 9 and make sure you let us know what you want to see in the DevOps series or just what you think and how you're building your applications. We hope that you found this useful and make sure you watch all of the great episodes that we have in store on DevOps for mobile developers. Abel, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
And thanks for watching.